Hi, good evening, everyone. I'm Anvesha Pandey, Deputy Director at NATEL, and I'm extremely delighted to welcome you all for the second session of the Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission webinar series, organized by NATEL in collaboration with National Health Authority, NHA. I would like to apologize for a few minutes delay. It was just a technical glitch. Sometimes it just happens. So, we all know that every week we will have an eminent speaker come on this platform and share their insights on one particular aspect of the Ayushman Bharat digital mission. And today we will be discussing design, architecture, and standards of Ayushman Bharat digital mission with Shri Abhishek Kumar, who's the Director IT at NHA. A very warm welcome to you, sir. We also have Dr. Anoop Amarnath from Manipal Hospitals, who will be moderating the session today. And I will need to specially welcome the legend of the diagnostic industry, Honorary Brigadier Dr. Arvind Lal Padma Shri, and also the past president of NatHealth and chair Fiki Swasth Bharat Task Force. He's also the executive chairman of Dr. Lal Path Labs Limited and managing trustee at Arvind Lal and Vandana Lal Foundation. He is the legend and the force behind bringing laboratory services in India at par with the Western world. He took charge of Dr. Lal Path Labs in 1977, and we all know where he has brought it. A very warm welcome to you, sir, and I will request to please give a welcome address for this occasion.
Thank you very much, Anvesha. Good evening, ladies and gentlemen, especially Mr. Abhishek Kumar and his team from NHA. Thank you, sir, for being with us. I'm extremely delighted to welcome all of you to the second session of Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission webinar series organized by NatHealth in collaboration with NHA and the entire healthcare industry, if I may say so. It is commendable to see the efforts of NatHealth with NHA in this mission. The entire private sector stands united for the cause, and the message is being spread across many federations and reaching the last mile. At the launch of the series, more than 12 federations were present at the auspicious occasion to show solidarity for the cause also. The private sector stands with the government for the cause and have our full support for the mission. The series targets to bring together all stakeholders, both public and private, on one platform to discuss widespread adoption and implementation of ABDM. Various aspects of ABDM implementation, like what we're going to discuss today, design challenges, infrastructure needs, role of startups, etc., will be covered through the entire string of these webinars. The series will serve as the myth buster for NDHM's futuristic vision and open doors for multiple stakeholders for willingly to fuse the vision of the NDHM. The series will cover many aspects of the mission every week, and we'll try to build a common awareness for everybody collaboratively and adopt the digital health roadmap of India. Several myths and misinformation will be dispelled, as the key architects of digital health strategy will answer all the questions. Today, we are going to cover the design, architecture, and standards of Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission, ABDM, with Shri Abhishek Kumar, Director IT at NHA. I'm honored to have you here, sir. Anvesha, please take over now. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Lal. Thank you for those encouraging words. I would now like to introduce our speaker, Shri Abhishek Kumar, who, of course, we all know. I'm really sorry that his camera was not able to work till now, but right now I just see that his camera is working. So a very warm welcome to you, sir. He's the Director IT at National Health Authority. He's an IRS from 2006 batch. In his current role, he is responsible to drive the accessibility and equity of health services, including continuum of care with citizens as the owner of data in the most citizen-centric approach. A very warm welcome to you, sir. We also have Dr. Anoop Amarnath, who is the moderator for our session. He's the chairman of the geriatric medicine and heads the internal medicine department at Manipal Hospitals, Bangalore. He has been the Chief of Clinical Services and CMIO. He's part of the Government of Karnataka's COVID Critical Care Support Group. A very warm welcome to you. And now I would request both of you to take this discussion forward. Over to you, Dr. Amarnath.
Yeah, thank you very much, Anvesha. And Dr. Lal, thank you so much for the introduction. And Sri Abhishek Kumarji, welcome. It's always a pleasure to work with the NHA. And of course, Mrs. Siddhartha, for providing the platform of NatHealth to disseminate this entire, I would say that it's a groundbreaking thing, the NDHM and the ABDM. So it's good to have all stakeholders on a single platform. And what we'll do over the course of the next 40 minutes is hear from Sri Abhishek Kumarji about specifically the standards, architecture, and design of the ABDM. So over to you, sir, for your presentation. After your presentation, we will have a discussion. There have been a lot of interest, a lot of questions from the audiences. So, and as we go live, we will be getting some more questions. So post your presentation, we can run through the questions and have an interaction. Over to you.
Thank you. Let me share a screen. Okay. I hope a screen is visible.
Yes, sir.
Yes, please go.
Just a second. So, as we know, Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission, it is a very ambitious project in the healthcare sector, and it seeks to break silos in healthcare sector. As we know, in healthcare, there are various digital systems, various types of softwares, HMIS systems are there, but they work in silos. And we won't be able to fully leverage this potential unless we are able to bridge gap between various systems, and various systems are able to talk to another. So that is the key point. Just give me 1 second. Next slide. So as we know, ABDM, Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission, which was earlier known as National Digital Health Mission, there is a long history to it. It started with National Health Policy of 2017. It talks about development of various registries and establishment of a federated National Health Information Architecture. Subsequently, in 2018, National Health Stack was released, and it talks about electronic registries, federated PHR framework. Finally, all these efforts culminated into National Digital Health Blueprint, which was released in December 2019. And it lays down detailed framework for digital health infrastructure. So basically, Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission, which was earlier known as National Digital Health Mission, is based upon the vision and mission of National Digital Health Blueprint. So what is the vision of this project? This project aims to create a national digital health ecosystem that supports universal health coverage in an efficient, accessible, inclusive, affordable, timely, and safe manner. And how it is to be done? It is to be done by duly leveraging open, interoperable, standards-based digital systems. We will discuss in detail what is the meaning of these terms and what are the implications. So as we discussed that various interventions in the digital healthcare sector are quite fragmented, and we intend to bridge this gap. Therefore, the architecture becomes very important and how we are ensuring it. So basically, it is open API based and interoperability is at the core of this mission. Federated architecture, that is a very important and key point of this project, that federated architecture is being followed. And federated architecture means that we are not creating any centralized database of any health records. The records will lie as it is, wherever they are, and no centralized database is being prepared. It will act as single source of truth. As we talked about registries, so various registries of HBDM will act as single source of truth. Participation in the project is voluntary, and privacy and security is being ensured by design. So these are some of the key principles of this project, and we will discuss in detail in subsequent slides. So the first point is, what is the problem statement? Because when we do any mission or any project, we need to know what are the issues or challenges or problems which we need to address. So currently, what are the challenges in the healthcare sector? Citizens do not have access to medical records. They do not have readily available and reliable information about doctors, hospitals, lab. They do not have adequate knowledge about qualification of doctor, choice to consult doctors remotely. Same problem is there even for hospitals, labs, doctor. Access to patients, medical history is a big challenge. So when it comes to policymakers or program managers level, again, information is required for formulating various policies or various kinds of medical interventions. And again, the information gap becomes a challenge. So these are some of the problem statements which this project, Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission, seeks to address. To understand the concept of ABDM, it is very important to understand this four-layered architecture. So at the very basic layer, we have JAM and other digital public goods like Aadhaar, UPI, e-sign, e-vouchers, DigiLocker, consent artifact. So basically, these digital building blocks are useful or they are used across sector. They are being used or they may be used in education, health, agriculture, any sector. On the top of that, domain specific layer needs to be created. So if you see second layer from the bottom, we have things like electronic registries, health records, health claims. So basically on the top of basic building blocks, we need to create domain specific layer. Only then the silos can be broken and interoperability can be ensured. Electronic registry means health ID, through which an individual can be identified in the digital world. Healthcare professional registry means the registry through which healthcare professionals like doctors, etc. can be identified. Health facilities mean the labs, the hospitals, the clinics, and their identification in the system. Then we need to create health information exchange and consent manager, which is already created as part of HBDM system. We are working for more than 1 year, and already most of these basic digital building blocks have been created. Then we need health data standards and aggregated health data for policy and health analytics. Health claims is an important component of this layer. So basically, this layer acts as the basic infrastructure which ensures interoperability in the system. On the top of that, there is UHI layer, Unified Health Interface layer. So basically, it is about APIs for health services. And when we say health services, it covers entire spectrum of health services like Discover Doctor, Book Appointment, Discover Lab, Discover Pharmacy, etc. On the top of that, at the topmost layer, there are various user facing application, they may be individual facing application or health provider facing application like Arogya Setu, e-Sanjeevani, various kinds of HIMS and LIMS system. So that is the overall architecture of ABDM at higher level. Now, to explain in simple terms, as we discussed, digital interventions in a healthcare are fragmented. So how do we ensure that various digital systems talk to one another? Let us understand in very simple layman terms. Two conditions need to be satisfied. First, we need common set of identifiers through which various entities like patients, doctors, hospitals, labs are identified in the digital ecosystem. Second, health data standards. That means various systems need to talk to one another in a common language. So this is about the digital part. Next part is about challenges in adoption. As we discussed, participation in ABDM is voluntary. So it is very important that various stakeholders in the ecosystem adopt ABDM. Only then the project can be successful. So here we can take an analogy to conversation between two individuals. Two individuals can make effective communication only if two conditions are satisfied. First, they need to know each other's identity. And second, they need to talk in one common language, right? Which can be understood by both. Only then there can be effective communication. So in the similar way, the registries are the building blocks of ABDM, which establish common identity in the digital world. And standards are the common speaking language in this digital health ecosystem. So these are the two basic requirements, and that is being taken care of through this project. Now, coming to ABDM, it is very important to understand that ABDM is not a centralized technology platform exclusively being managed by government, right? Because through ABDM, we seek to enable an ecosystem known as National Digital Health Ecosystem. So such an ecosystem can be established only if all players in the ecosystem, be it government entity or private entities, participate effectively. So there are three types of building blocks in ABD: core building blocks, common building blocks, and reference building blocks. Core building blocks are exclusive to ABD. That means they will be definitely be maintained at centralized level. They are health ID, health facility registry, healthcare professional registry, or any other registry. Please note that these registries are merely for identification and no centralized data of health records as such are being maintained. It is just for establishing identity with minimum data sets pertaining to an individual, like let us say name, year of birth, gender, etc. So very basic data fields are being taken. Common building blocks means the building blocks which can be maintained by both government and private application. For example, you can see NDHM or ABDM health records application, which is available on Google Play Store. So these applications, this application is currently being maintained by ABDM. However, such applications are not monopoly of the government and they can be developed by private players as well. In fact, the intent is that there should be enough choices to consumers when it comes to choice for these kinds of applications and services. Then there is a reference building block segment, like for a health locker or wellness applications. No development will take place in ABDM. Only specifications or guidelines will be provided. So these are three key registries of ABDM, although this is not exhaustive list of registries in ABDM. Health ID, as we already discussed, for identification of patients, and it can be created by any user through our web application or mobile application. Healthcare professional registry for identification of professionals like doctors, and the health facility registry for identification of facility. All these applications are based upon self-registration, and all eligible persons, professionals, individuals, facilities can register on the portal. There is very simple process of registration. Now, this is the architecture of ABPM. So I will take some time to explain it in detail. On the left side, we can see public health programs, hospitals, diagnostic centers, and clinics. These are the entities where information is generated. When I say information, here I mean information related to health condition of an individual, like let us say prescription, discharge summary, diagnostic reports, etc. On the right side, again, we have public health programs, hospitals, clinics, PHR application, health locker. So these are the applications, or these are the entities which consume the information. Like let us say someone visits a hospital. So in the hospital, the person may be required to present earlier medical records. So the hospital is generator of information, medical information or medical records, as well as creator of these health records. So on the left side, we have what we call in ABDM terminology, HIP, which is health information provider. On the right hand side, we have something called HIU, which is health information user. On the left side, you can see that there is something called HRP. So what is this HRP? What happens is that any hospitals or labs or clinics may be using some software for management of their patients inflow as well as their treatment. So that is called health repository provider. So it is basically a software which is used by any hospital, commonly known as HIMS system, health information management system. On the right side, these entities are called HIU, that is health information user. And in the center, we can see we have NDHM building blocks. What is NDHM building blocks? So it consists of health ID, facility registry, healthcare professional registry, or any other registry which identifies players on the left or right side of this slide. Then we have consent manager and gateway. So as we discussed in ABDM, first of all, we are not creating any centralized repository of information. Secondly, any exchange of information can take place only with the consent of the individual. So this consent manager and gateway is basically for ensuring exchange of information based upon consent. So this is the basic framework. So suppose this HIU on the right side requests some information about a person. That request lands on NDHM building block, which is consent manager and gateway, where based upon health ID, the consent manager and gateway already knows what are the hospitals, HIPs or HRPs, where the information pertaining to that person is lying. And accordingly, the requested information, for requested information, first of all, that individual is notified. Once the person gives consent, then the notification is sent to corresponding HIP, health information provider, to share that information, and the information reaches HIU, health information user, which requested the information. Sorry. So this is the basic construct and architecture of ABDM, which enables exchange of information without creating any centralized repository of health records. So let us understand how end user experience changes with ABD. So a person can register at hospital using health ID. Medical records get linked to health ID. The moment the person goes out of hospital, and opens ABDM health records application. Now ABDM, a person can log in into ABDM health records mobile application using a health ID. The moment records get linked to health ID, the link becomes visible on the mobile app, and the person can even download medical record using this link. Then there is capability to share records using ABDM health records application. So suppose the person visits hospital and the doctor sitting on the HMIS application interface requests for, let us say, last 3 years medical records. So the request lands upon the ABDM health records application, and the person receives notification that the doctor wants to see your last 3 years record. Once the person gives consent, then the records become visible to the doctor who requested for those medical records. So that is how exchange of information becomes very easy with the operationalization of ABDM. Now, ABDM operates in plug and play model. Can anybody register in any hospital or clinic using a health ID? There is a small step involved before any person can register using health ID. The software being used in any hospital or lab need to be integrated with ABDM, and that is through sandbox integration process. Anybody can visit ABDM website. There is a simple form for sandbox integration. They can fill up the form, and after that they are provided sandbox keys, and accordingly integration can start. And there are four types of constructs in our ABDM. We already discussed health information provider, health information user, health repository provider, and a health locker. So basically, health locker is another construct where a person can decide to pull the records and store it into health locker. So that is the additional facility available to the user whosoever joins ABDM. So that is the basic construct of ABDM. And just to emphasize our point, ABDM doesn't change any basic construct of healthcare system. The records, the type of exchange, the framework of exchange and communication between patients and healthcare professionals remain the same. The individual continues to be in control of data. The data principle is in absolute command of the health records, and nothing can be exchanged without consent of the individual. Thank you.
Thank you, sir. I think that was a wonderful presentation, very eloquent, and a lot of clarity, especially in terms of the health provider, healthcare user, and the repository companies. So if you're okay with it, there have been a lot of questions, and we shall open, we'll have a few Q&As. I know there is a time constraint as well, but I think in the interest of the larger public, we can go through a few questions. The first question is from the Jahangir Hospital. Now, one of the questions which they've asked is the HIS. You know, a lot of hospitals use the HIS systems. Would there be any kind of standardization required so that they are ABDM compatible? Is that something what we're looking at?
Yes, actually, any hospital will have to go through an integration process. And here one important point is that integration is mainly at the level of software being used in the hospital. So let us say some hospital is using e-hospital software. So that e-hospital software has to be integrated with ABDM, and that facility has to be registered in health facility registry. So it is a simple process of integration through our sandbox, and after that it will become ABDM compliant. The people will be able to register at the hospital using a health ID, and their records will be available on the ABDM mobile application to be shared in the ecosystem.
Right. Thank you very much. So the next question is about consent. There is a question about in cases like an emergency ICU admission. You've shown us in your presentation that there is a big component of consent, and through that, you know, the health information moves around. So the question is about in an emergency situations like an ICU admission, how do we handle consent for the previous EHRs?
For these situations, we are building a concept of nominee in our system. So let us say I have created a health ID. I can create a nominee using the same system. And in such scenarios, consent may be enabled through these nominees. We are still working upon it, and we will come up with this idea of nominee. So hopefully that will take care of such scenarios.
Excellent. Thank you very much. The next question is from the J&J Group. Now, as you know, that a lot of the private sector would want to partner with the government in terms of either capacity building or skilling in terms of rolling out ADHM and ABDM. So the question specifically is, are there any specific areas which the private sector can partner with the government, specifically about, you know, the ABDM capacity building and skilling, because there's a lot of skilling gap that we see if this has to be rolled out. So do you foresee a scenario where the private sector can partner with the government in skilling and capacity building?
This is a very important area, and it is very rightly pointed out that since ABDM seeks to create a new ecosystem, capacity building will be very important. And convincing people to adopt the system, enabling them to adopt the system. So that is definitely a very important area which is being considered at ABDM. And as we also discussed, since ABDM is about creation of a new ecosystem, participation of entire ecosystem, both government and private entities involved in the ecosystem is very important for the success of this project. So we will definitely come up with something which specifically takes care of private sector participation, specific to capacity building. We keep on having various kinds of consultations with various types of players, and that way we are already proactively engaging industry and all relevant classes. But we will specifically look into this area, and we will see what is the best way to tap private sector potential in this area.
Thank you. And no better platform than NatHealth to ensure that we engage the private sector and all ecosystem players into this one. Now, you were talking about the sandboxer. So are there any kind of a specific kind of startups that are already working with the NDHM and working in building things around the ABDM as a part of the sandbox as such?
Yeah, so if I understood this question correctly, our ABDM sandbox environment is fully operational, and already there are a large number of integrators who are very actively working with us. Many of them are already live in our production environment. And there are many HMIS system, LMIS systems, which have already integrated with us. There are various hospitals, labs, where people can register using a health ID, and their records get linked to their health ID. So that way the system is already operational, and this ABDM sandbox ecosystem is evolving quite well. And there are so many integrators who have completed their integration. There are so many integrators who are in the process of integration.
Excellent. Now, when you had the presentation with the healthcare repository and healthcare user and provider, are there any guidelines around the choice of tech stack, primarily in the D2C space? Because at the end of the day, the consumer needs to benefit from this entire thing. So are there any guidelines towards the D2C space in the tech stack?
I didn't fully get this question. Are you asking about the choice of any HMIS system? Or
The question which was asked was, when we're going direct to consumer, so when the consumer is using this, so we are looking at, are you going to give any guidelines for people who develop those applications which are directly being used by the consumers?
As we discussed, role of ABDM is just to create an enabling building block, right? And it is for ecosystem to develop various kinds of applications which can be leveraged by the consumers. So basically, it is left to market dynamics, how people decide their applications, which applications are most convenient to them, which applications are able to deliver services to them in the best possible manner. As far as ABDM is concerned, we are just concerned about only 2-3 basic aspects, like they should be compliant to ABDM registries and their standards. They should be compliant to various kinds of information security standards or other guidelines published by us. Beyond that, it is absolutely choice of the consumer, and it depends upon the value proposition as offered by the application and as perceived by the consumers.
Right. So thank you so much, sir. And I think this is a right point before we wind up for me to get Dr. Lal, you know, as Anvisha rightly discussed, a legend in Indian healthcare in the diagnostic space. So the ABDM, I know the diagnostic space in terms of lab workup, you know, Lal Pathlabs have done a lot of work in the past about digitalizing healthcare. So Dr. Lal, would you want to kind of give us a quick comment on your experience in digitalizing the labs and enabling, you know, people to use the lab services, and how you foresee the implementation of ABDM changing this entire healthcare paradigm?
So thank you, Anoop. The fact of the matter is that we are, you know, very, very heavily dependent on what we call a lab information management system. And then there is the front, part where the registration takes place. Then there's a background part. So about, you know, 4 such systems are actually running our, you know, integrated system. And supposing we are dealing with the hospital, well, we given the inputs, and he can link into our system directly, and with his HIS or HL7, as you call it, you know, he can get into our system. So it's working pretty smoothly. I mean, if anybody wants to come and have a look, our system the data center was designed by IBM. And it is also maintained by IBM. And of course, it's got a disaster, you know, secondary site also. And we can go test up till about 1 lakh patients in a day. So that is the kind of volumes we have. And our only concern would be that when we are linking up with, you know, a non-private system, a government system, what are the chances of somebody getting into our system and, you know, taking away patients' confidential data, or hacking the system? But these days, all these kind of stories we are hearing every day. So that was our, concern to start. It's too premature to even, you know, talk about these things. But patient confidentiality and hacking is something, you know, which we will have to grapple with sooner or later. Mr. Abhishek, if you could, I know this is not the right time, but since Anoop gave me a chance, so I said, might as well.
Yeah, so we'll wind up with the last question, Sri Abhishek ji, about data security. If you can touch upon that as one of the concluding points for us, please.
Yeah. So let me explain about this data security aspect. This question is raised again and again at various platforms. So we need to understand a few basic points. Obviously, in digital world, security question is always there, and we need to be fully updated to ensure that data security is never compromised. But there are a few key points. First point is that through ABDM, first of all, we are not changing the basic contours or the basic rules of engagement. Any consultation, any treatment will happen in the same manner post enablement of ABDM as it used to happen earlier. So first of all, ABDM is not leading to any increase in risk as far as security is concerned. The same risk which was there earlier, it will be there in future, and we need to be vigilant about that. There is no doubt about that. Second point is that it is a federated architecture. We are not creating any centralized database of health records. Third point is that any data sharing in the ecosystem is based upon consent. So just like today, the individual is in command and in full control of the information. Fourth point, about the risk of hacking and everything, we have our information security policies, which are fully with international standards, and we ensure that our systems are fully compliant with our information security policies. Not only our internal systems, any external system getting integrated to ABDM have to comply to information security policy, which we have separately published for any party integrating with us. So through these measures, we are quite confident that there is no risk to security of information. And definitely, whatever risk was there earlier, that remains as far as data security is concerned. And all of us need to be very much vigilant about.
Thank you very much, sir, because that was an excellent talk, eloquent, and a lot of clarity about what ABDM does and what ABDM can do and how people can come together, both the private and the public sector, to make sure, you know, digital health has always been the holy grail of medicine. And if we can crack it, I think it will be a world's first and one of the world's largest digital health systems. So we look forward, you know, to working very closely with the government, and, you know, these platforms provide a very good opportunity for us to interact and then disseminate the right information across to all stakeholders. So thank you once again for coming on board. And Anvesha, over to you for the concluding remarks.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you so much, sir. What an enriching session this was. Thank you so much for taking out time and, you know, coming on this platform and enlighten us on the subject. Thank you, Dr. Anupamanath, also to moderate the session. And my special thank you to Dr. Arvind Lal, who's also our past president, for his for coming and joining on this session. I would also like to thank the Avian team and the HealthWiz team who have been here to provide the back-end support. And I need to specially mention here Vishwa from NHA, whom I have been coordinating throughout to make this webinar successful. Even Vikram and Babita for their support. They are from the NHA team. I would like to express my gratitude to all the participants who have joined this session and also for their questions. If we were not able to answer your questions in this session due to some time constraints, please don't worry. We will be answering all those questions on our blog of naturalseries.com. So please do check it out. We will be posting the answers there shortly. And, you know, we will be back next Thursday on December 9 to cover yet another aspect of the Ayushman Bharat Digital Mission with Dr. Ajay Bakshi, who is the advisor at NHA. And we will be discussing how can hospitals adopt and use ABDM-linked solutions? So till then, stay tuned and keep reading about us on this webinar series on the naturalseries.com, our blog. And please feel free to watch all our videos, this one and the past videos for this session, for this series on our YouTube channel. And don't forget to like and subscribe us. Till then, bye-bye and take care.